Welcome to RIRCOM.
Bipolar transistor. If we now join together two individual signal diodes back to back, this will give us two PN junctions connected together in series that share a common P or N terminal. The fusion of these two diodes produces a three-layer two-junction, three-terminal device forming the basis of a bipolar junction transistor, or BJT for short. Transistors are three-terminal active devices made from different semiconductor materials that can act as either an insulator or a conductor by the application of small signal voltage. The transistor's ability to change between these two states enables it to have two basic functions, switching or amplifications. The bipolar transistors have the ability to operate within three different regions. One is active region. The transistor operates as an amplifier and collector current IC is equal to beta into base current IB. Next, saturation. The transistor is fully on, operating as a switch, and the collector current IC is equal to I saturation. The last one is cutoff. The transistor is fully off, operating as a switch, and the collector current IC is equal to zero. The word transistor is a combination of the two words transfer varistor, which describes their mode of operation way back in the early days of electronics development. There are two basic types of bipolar transistor construction, PNP and NPN, which basically describes the physical arrangement of the P-type and N-type semiconductor materials from which they are made. Bipolar transistors are current regulating devices that control the amount of current flowing through them in a proportion to the amount of biasing voltage applied to their base terminal, acting like a current controlled switch. The principle of operation of the two transistor types, PNP and NPN, is exactly the same, the only difference being in their biasing and the polarity of the power supply for each type. See the figure. Transistor is a three-terminal device, namely base, collector and emitter. The base is responsible for activating the transistor. The collector terminal is positive lead. The emitter terminal is negative lead. See the diagrams for bipolar transistor construction for both PNP and NPN transistors. You can see in this diagram physical construction and equivalent diagram for two diodes analogy, and also final you can see the circuit symbols. The construction and circuit symbols for both the PNP and NPN bipolar transistors are given above with the arrow in the circuit symbol, always showing the direction of conventional current flow between the base terminal and its emitter terminal. The direction of the arrow always points from the positive P-type region to the negative N-type region for both transistor types, exactly the same as for the standard diode symbol. Bipolar transistor configurations. As the bipolar transistor is a three-terminal device, there are basically three possible ways to connect it within an electronic circuit, with one terminal being common to both the input and output. Each method of connection responding differently to its input signal within a circuit, as the static characteristics of the transistor varies with each circuit arrangement. See the diagram for three types of transistor configuration. One is common base configuration. It has voltage gain but no current gain. Next one is common emitter configuration. It has both current and voltage gain. Finally, see the common collector configuration. It has high current gain but no voltage gain. See the comparison table to differentiate the properties of common base, common emitter and common collector configurations. Mostly the common emitter configuration is used in practical. Transistor biasing. To operate a transistor, emitter junction should be in forward bias and collector junction should be in reverse bias. See the diagram for types of biasing: current biasing, feedback biasing, double feedback biasing, voltage divider biasing, double base biasing. Advantages of transistor: it is smaller mechanical sensitivity, low cost and smaller in size, especially in small signal circuits. Low operating voltages for greater safety, lower cost and tighter clearances. Extremely long life, no power consumption by a cathode heater, fast switching. Important specifications of a transistor: current gain IHFE. This is a measure of the amplifying ability of the transistor. It refers to the ratio of the base current to the collector current. Typical values range from 50 to 200. The higher this number, the more the transistor is able to amplify an incoming signal. Collector to emitter voltage VCEO, the maximum voltage across the collector and the emitter. This is usually 30 volt or more, which is well above the voltage levels we work with in most hobby circuits. Emitter to base voltage VEBO, the maximum voltage across the emitter and the base. This is usually a relatively small number, such as 6 volt. Most circuits are designed to apply only small voltage to the base, so this limit is not usually a concern. Collector to base voltage VCBO, the maximum voltage across the collector and the base. This is usually 50 volts or more. Collector current IC, the maximum current that can flow through the collector to emitter path. Using a resistor to limit this current flow. The value of the resistor must be calculated using Ohm's law to keep the collector current below the limit. If we exceed this limit for long, the transistor may be damaged. Total power dissipation PD. This is the total power that can be dissipated by the device. For most small transistors, the power rating is on the order of a few hundred milliwatts.
Thank you. Watch, subscribe and like.